Today we'll see about the medical entomology part 1, that is the identification of arthropod and the disease caused by this arthropod. If you have not subscribed our channel, do subscribe for more interesting videos like this, and as well don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will receive a daily video notification. We'll see about the classification of arthropods and the arthropods coming under class Insecta except mosquitoes, which we'll be seeing in next video, and a quick recap. When coming to classification of the phylum Arthropoda, it is classified as Insecta, Arachnida and Crustata. To make it more easier, we'll have this mnemonic. When someone is asked about an insect, one thing will come is it will always fly mostly, and another thing is it has an antenna. But both these characters, that is the wing for flying and the antenna, are actually absent in Arachnida. We'll remember, like Arachnida, Aragora, so it will not have the wing as well the antenna, whereas Insecta and Crustata will have the wings and antenna. Coming to Insecta, we have mosquitoes, flies, fleas, human lice and reduvid bug, of which we'll see flies, fleas, human lice and reduvid bug. First is housefly. Housefly is actually falling under a genus called Musca. When we write M, it has 1, 2, 3, 4 stripes or lines. So it has 4 stripes. It is considered as longitudinal. So it is, we'll consider this two only. So it is longitudinal stripes. On reconstructing this M by putting a very small line here like this, it becomes a part that is thorax. So 4 longitudinal stripes on thorax is the identification of genus Musca, and all the house flies comes under genus Musca, thereby they have 4 longitudinal stripes on the thorax. These house flies are known to have the index of insanitation. They will be sitting in one place and not move because these secrete a sticky fluid, and what is actually secreting sticky fluid is the tenant hair. The tenant hair, which is distributed in the legs and some part of the body, secrete the sticky fluid which makes it sit. And one other important thing about the housefly is the vomit drop. It vomits on the solid food and sucks in. This vomit drop is what is seen here. This vomit drop is actually taken for culture for identification of the disease. It is usually having the habit of flying 4 miles from the breeding place. Now coming to disease caused by this house fly, it is put it ulta, flying house. When something is flying in the house, everyone will sit down. And having this as a mnemonic itself, what are the things that is excreted from the body downwards? One is urine, and another is the stool, and another is the tears. So we not consider to urine and house fly stools. Yes, it is going to cause acute gastroenteritis and tears. It is concerned with the eye, and one important thing for T40 is trachoma and some conjunctivitis. This is caused by housefly is acute gastroenteritis, like it is cholera, typhoid, dysentery, amebiasis, etc. And as well, it is going to cause a trachoma and also anthrax, YAS, poliomyelitis, etc. Next is sandfly. One important thing to note in sandfly is it is hairy. It has hair all over the body. It is smaller than the mosquitoes, and it is again falling under a genus of Phlebotomus. When we draw a vinite P like this, and again we reconstruct this to be a wing, then in the middle of the wing there is a branch. This is to be remembered. There is something branching in the middle, and what is that is the second longitudinal vein is going to branch in the middle. So we write P like this. In the middle there is something branching like that. Actually it is the second longitudinal vein that is branching in the wing. That is the characteristic feature in the Phlebotomus genus that is seen in sandfly. Here the sandfly will be flying 50 yards from the breeding place and create nuisance. It is causing a painful bite, especially at night, because it is going to bite on every third or the fourth day. It is for oviposition. The disease caused by this sandfly fever, oriental sore. Add to that one thing we'll say, because sandfly is going to bite at night. When someone is asking us what is the disease caused by sandfly, we know only one thing, that sandfly is going to bite at night. Our answer will be kalaila illa sir. Okay, so when you try to say this kalaila illa sir fast, it becomes kala sir. So the disease caused transmitted by this is kala azar. Next is sedge fly. This sedge fly, one thing to remember is it is similar to the house fly, and it has a non-retractile proboscis. This non-retractile proboscis is a very important thing, because in house fly it is a retractile proboscis, here it is a non-retractile proboscis. The disease caused by this is as simple as this, T40 trypanosomiasis, or yes, that is sleeping sickness. It is seen in Africa, and therefore the place where all the sedge fly is there, that is called as the fly belt. So it is going to cause trypanosomiasis or African sleeping sickness. Next is the black fly. As this name suggests, black, it will be like black only. And what the disease caused by this black fly is, when everything becomes black, that is when someone is going blind, the people is going to see everything black like that. So having this in mind, one parasite that causing blindness is onchocerciasis. So this black fly is going to carry the parasite of onchocerciasis, and thereby causing onchocerciasis. Black fly, onchocerciasis. It belongs to a genus called Simulum. We remember, like sim is going to enter into the phone. So likewise, this black flies is going to enter into something to lay egg, and that is the aquatic region. Under water it is going to lay egg.